Hi friends, hopefully those of you who are still struggling in life today are given strength and abundant fortune. This time we will learn to calculate the circulation value of a velocity field. The circulation passes through four different points as seen on your screen. I think this question is quite simple. Before entering the discussion sheet, maybe you don't remember the circulation formula. This is a side view of a fluid flow. At one point, the velocity of the fluid particles is as follows. Let's say we want to calculate the circulation value of a closed curve. The value of circulation on this curve is the closed path integral of the vector v dot vector ds. The circulation is measured on a closed curve. So the integration process will be carried out along the curve. I think we have understood the concept of closed path integrals correctly. Without further ado, let's go to the discussion sheet. The velocity field equation has been written on the question sheet. From the velocity field equation, we know that the velocity has velocity components on the x-axis and y-axis. That is the velocity field in two-dimensional space. This is quite important, we must know the shape of the closed curve. It seems that all of those points are in two-dimensional Cartesian coordinates. This is point 1, point 2, point 3, and point 4. Connect each point to form a box. This is the shape of a closed curve. This curve does not provide enough data. The curve must have a direction. If it is not mentioned, we are free to choose the direction of the curve. Let's say the direction of the curve is counterclockwise. Now we can calculate the circulation value on this curve. Just write gamma equals the closed path integral of the vector v dot vector ds. Since the path is in the form of a box, there are four lines. The closed path integral can be written into four integrals. We have known the velocity field. In the two-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system, the vector ds is the vector dxi hat, plus dyj hat. We will do the integration process four times. The first is from point 1 to point 2. The line formed is a horizontal line. The ordinate value at each point on the line is the same, which is 1. This means that there is no change in the y-axis, the dy factor is none. In the same way, from point 2 to point 3 there is only a change in the y-axis. The value of x is 2. Likewise on the other paths. Next is dot product. In dot product, the multiplication of unequal unit vectors will produce a value of 0. Now the integration process looks simpler. I think this integration process is very easy. You can enter the upper and lower limits of integration. The result is plus 9, plus 18, minus 36, minus 4.5. Gamma is equal to minus 13.5 meters squared per second. What does this value mean? The negative sign on gamma indicates that the direction of the fluid velocity through the closed path is opposite to the direction of the loop. Happy learning, everyone.
I like to be educated, but I'm so frustrated. Hello to my loneliness. I guess that ignorance is bliss.